have contributed enormously to the whole ukulele revival scene around here in all kinds of wonderful ways. Marlene Wong, who's the music and dance librarian at Smith, conceived the idea of us doing a combined Smith Forbes holiday sing and jam. And we've done it, is it twice or three times? Twice, it feels like three. So, and if you didn't come last time, or if you did come last time, you should all come next time. And they were all here, and it's totally great. And
there's
the family. That's all, they'll tell you.
Bailey.
Now, he's best known, perhaps, for coining the phrase, absence makes the heart grow fonder. Now, if that tune sounds a little bit familiar, well, you know, about 100 years later, someone wrote new words, gave it a bouncier rhythm, and voila, we got. Don't sit under the apple tree with anyone else but me. No.
The sing-along will be after the show.
Our next song is Gather Ye Rosebuds While Ye May. Words by Robert Peck and William Laws, who was court composer to Charles I of England, Scotland, and Ireland, who might have known something about seizing the day, given that he was Mary Queen of Scots' grandson. Gather Ye Rosebuds.
Cobbler's Jig. The composer is unknown. It was probably played in taverns and pubs. Here is the Cobbler's Jig.
Speed. Ill is the weather that bringeth no gain. forsake you, soul, and drown it merrily.
And many of them are still popular today, such as Old Susanna, Jeannie with the Light Brown Hair, My Old Kentucky Home, and this one, which I have a feeling many of you are going to know.
Thank you.
can see a lot of people know that song. I've never seen so many people sing along with the song. It was pretty amazing. On Wings of Song is an art song by Felix Mendelssohn, who also wrote The Wedding March from A Midsummer Night's Dream. And an art song is one that's composed in the classical style, usually for a single voice and piano, and often takes its text from a poem. This particular piece of music is set to a poem originally written in German by Heinrich Heine. And as I mentioned, the title is On Wings of Song.
Or A Flügeln des Gesanges.
Thank you. You know, here at the Forbes Library, we know we're going to have a very educated group, so we figured we'd give you the German title. We're going to sing it in English, however.
Fell in love with that instrument there after 20 years of of being a professional ballet dancer with such major companies like the Joffrey Ballet and the Metropolitan Opera Ballet. She teaches ukulele locally, and she's a professional illustrator known for her on-site drawings at live music shows.
Thank you, Marlene. Richard Perlmutter is our musical ringer in this group. Besides the ukulele, Richard plays classical guitar, piano, and mandolin. And he has produced music for Grammy Award-winning people like Tom Paxton and Nickel Creek. And as a recording artist himself, he has been nominated for the Grammy 4 times for his work as lyricist, lead singer, and producer of the Beethoven's Wing series of recordings. Richard also does most of our arrangements.
This is Marlene Wong. And Marlene Wong, in case you haven't noticed, is our resident researcher. She is a art, music, theater, dance, librarian specialist.
I'm not an art librarian.
Oh, not an art. See, you know, I got so carried away.
But the rest of that sounds true.
The rest of it is true. She actually is also a classically trained organist, and she is a longtime You know, I tried to actually learn these lines. I know all about Marlene, so I'm just going to ad lib, all right? Marlene's the greatest. She is a longtime church musician and vocal coach. She also has long-term projects in mid-20th century American art song. And she is also very happy to be performing on these truly portable and... what else about
them?
Portable instruments and versatile instruments. That's right. So anyway, that's us.
Yeah.
So I guess the next up, thank you. So thank you. And our next song is actually going to feature Robin. And this is a sea shanty from the late 1600s, or as we like to call it, a good old-fashioned pirate song. The composer is unknown, but we're going to take it away.
Hey, Anonymous could have been a woman.
Probably was.
Yeah,
probably was. And you know, since I am going to sing it tonight, you're welcome to imagine that it was written by a woman. Okay. Let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Yo ho ho, yo ho ho.
Look ahead, look astern, look the weather and the lee.
Blow high, blow, and so sail it.
I see a wreck to windward and a lofty ship to lee, a sailing down along the coast of high Barbary. Yo ho ho, yo ho ho. Are you a pirate, a man of war, cry we?
Blow high, blow, and so sail it we.
Oh no, I'm not a pirate, but a man of war, cry we, a sailing down along the coast of high Barbary. Their coffin and their grave, it was the sea, a sailing down along the coast of high Barbary. Since First I Saw Your Face is famously considered the most beautiful of Elizabethan airs, we will be performing Marlene's own arrangement of this beautiful love song. It was written by Thomas Ford, and Marlene's arrangement is actually inspired by a 19th century imprint.
She was instructed to give me a lot of time.
Well, I do have more to say. I'd like you all to know that over by the visitor book over there, we have some bookmarks and some stickers that say Well-Tempered Ukes on them. And those are free and they're for you. So please make sure you help yourself to one before you leave today.
I say that because I go from the lowest note that I sing in this program to one of the higher ones. And so it's like I have to like think about this a little bit. So
it doesn't matter, I like to talk.
Yeah. Yeah.
people ask me about this little instrument. This thing is a mandolinetto. And a mandolinetto, musically, is a mandolin. It basically has the same setup as a mandolin, same strings and everything else. But in shape, it is much more akin to a ukulele. So if you happen to be in a ukulele band and you want the sound of a mandolin, this thing is just the ticket. Now we also have quite an array of ukuleles here, as you can see. And as soon as I put this one down and pick up my others, Robin is going to give you a short tour of our collection of instruments.
Well, tonight we have a pretty good example of the ukulele family, actually, which you'll see in a moment. Dr. Seuss would like this.
That's right.
I think.
This is the best part of the show.
Richard is holding in his left hand the largest ukulele, and it has the lowest notes of all of our ukuleles. That is a baritone ukulele. It is actually tuned just like the top four strings of a guitar. Now, next in line, next in size, this is a tenor ukulele. And next is a concert ukulele, and this is a soprano ukulele. All three of these in the middle are tuned the same. Ukulele C tuning is what we use. And if you're, you know, if you're a guitar player and you don't know about ukes yet, if you take your guitar and you capo your fifth fret, why, it'll play just like a uke. In this concert, Marlene also plays a soprano-sized banjo-lele, or banjo-ukulele. Some people object to calling it banjo-lele for some reason. It is built just like a little banjo, and it sounds just like a little banjo, but it's a real ukulele. It's tuned just like these guys. Now, there's just one more, this little tiny sopranino, right? Mine has a little fish on it. The sopranino has the highest notes of all of our ukuleles. Believe it or not, this little thing is tuned like Richard's baritone, just one octave higher. So my chord shapes on this are the same as his chord shapes on that one, and the chord shapes on the rest of these are all the same. And that brings us around full circle, I think.
No coloratura.
No, not now. Well, they're all, I mean, depends on how you play it, I suppose.
Question. Could you play the four notes?
We can do that. Yes,
do that.
Here we are. Here are the four notes.
Then
my dog has fleas.
Yeah, you play.
We're going to play the four. First, we'll play.
Did you want to hear these?
I want to hear the two end ones.
Ones, yeah. Oh, the little ones, yes.
Play your four notes.
So it doesn't have, it's not my dog has fleas because this note is tuned lower.
Yeah,
right.
But bar your 12th fret and do it.
There you go.
50. Okay, I think I'm supposed to say something else now. Yes, I am. Thank you. Okay, well, just so you don't think that we only like really old music, we are now going to play some music that's not very old at all. These next three songs are songs that we sang together in the community ukulele club right here in Northampton that we all belong to and where we met. And it's called the AEIO Ukes, and some of you here are not also members of the AEIO Ukes.
There are a few dedicated members in the audience.
Yeah, and it's if you want to play the ukulele, you will be guaranteed to find a lot of nice people who also like to play the ukulele and sing. Let me take a sip of water.
Water break. Ready?
Yes.
Without your sweet love, but
I'm not going to say that thing about unrequited love.
You're not going to say that thing about unrequited love? You mean that this could be another song about unrequited love?
That's what I'm not going to say.
Falling.
coming up to our last two songs. So, what a great audience, I must say. You know, here's what I'm supposed to say. You guys are a great audience. You're a great audience. And geez, people are actually boo-hooing because we have to stop. It's wonderful. Thank you, son. You're such a nice audience. I really appreciate it. We have really enjoyed playing for you. And our last two songs are from the time of Shakespeare. The first one is by John Bartlett, and it's called When From My Love. And the last one is by Thomas Campion, and it's called, what's it called? Never Weather Beaten Sail. All right. Some of you may know these songs out there. Oh. One, two, a one, two, hey. When from my love I looked for love and kind affections to
hey.
Well, I found her vows to prove most faithless and untrue. When from my love I looked for love and kind affections due,
hey.
Well, I found her vows to prove most faithless and untrue. For when I did ask her why, she did reply that she with me did ne'er agree to love but jestingly. Fix their constancies like feathers in the wind. Mark what the subtle policies that female lovers find.
Hey.
Who love to fix their constancies like feathers in the wind.
Though
they swear vow and protest
them.
They love you chiefly best. Yet by and by they all deny and say 'twas but in jest. Never Weather Beaten Sail by Thomas Campion. But before we finish up, once again, thank you very much. And also thank the Forbes Library for hosting us, Faith Kaufman for arranging this whole thing. Mrs. Bonnie Burnham has been filming us, and we appreciate that too. For us. And we have a few little announcements here. Marlene, would you like to kick the first announcement off?
Our next gig is going to be at Art Walk East Hampton on August 8th. If you happen to be going, come by and see us. We'll be performing at 6:30 at White Square Books in East Hampton. So, and I understand that there's wine, cheese, and air conditioning. So,
reasons to go.
Yeah. Oh, and my announcements had to do again with bookmarks and stickers. Please take one home. Of course, we have a website, and of course, we have a Facebook page, and
we love it if you like us.
And we are the Well-Tempered Ukes.
And we are the Well-Tempered Ukes.
Here comes our last song. Thanks once again. Wait a second.
Hey, too much.
I got so excited. I just, I had
too much cola. Cola.
Okay, let's try it again. One. Let's try it again. We can do it better. I know we can. Ready? One, two. One, two. I gotta get my whistle ready. Oh, I'm gonna wet my whistle to get it going. We gotta end with a bang, so just hang on. Ready?